Hello everyone, today's topic is map projection. Before map projection, we need to learn about cartography. Cartography is a science of making maps. Carto means the paper and graphy means to write about, right? So science and art of map making is known as cartography. Before the cartography was invented, the first ever made map was found in Babylonia on a clay tablet. You can see in this image. Let's understand map projection. What are map projection? The earth is spherical in shape. Earth is curved. So the curved surface of earth cannot be accurately transformed on or drawn on a flat surface of paper or a map. So it is very difficult to transfer the curved surface of curved surfaces on flat surface of paper, because of which we experience distortion. Distortion means what? Inaccuracy which are seen on map. That is why the cartographers use different types of map projection to avoid all these types of distortion or inaccuracy on map. Let's understand the three major types of projection. First is cylindrical or Mercator's projection, second is conical, and third is planar or azimuthal projection. In cylindrical projection, a sheet of paper is wrapped around the globe and the maps are made on that. In conical projection, a paper cone is rested on the globe and the maps are drawn. And in planar or azimuthal projection, a flat sheet of paper is kept on any part of the globe and the maps are made. First projection is Mercator's projection. It is drawn as if a globe is wrapped with the flat sheet of paper and the paper is kept as the cylinder and covers the globe. So Mercator's projection has all the latitudes and longitude. Meridians means longitude and parallels means latitude. They all are straight and they intersect each other at right angles. Now because of this, what happens that we are able to use this Mercator's projection. Just by drawing a line, we can navigate to any place, right? The scales can be used to measure the distance between, when we want to find out the distance between these two places, we can just keep a scale and convert them so that we can get the actual distance between the two places, especially in equatorial area. This projection is often used for navigational purpose. The people who are on ship, they use these maps, Mercator's projection. Why? Because it is simply, we can simply use the direction looking at the maps. So all the latitudes and longitudes are straight in this Mercator's projection. It is easy for navigational purpose. But the one disadvantage of Mercator's projection is that landmasses are heavily distorted, especially east and west of the map. So you can see over here the size of Greenland is distorted, right? Antarctica is distorted. So the landmasses to the north and south, they are heavily distorted, they are extended. This is the disadvantage of Mercator's projection. Second is azimuthal projection, where a sheet of paper is touching any part of the globe, right? So this azimuthal map projection is a flat plane projection. It's very accurate when the area where the paper is touching the globe, right? There are no distortion at this place where the paper touches the globe, but as the places away from the area where the paper is touching the globe are also having the distortion. Azimuthal projections, here the grids are represented as spherical shape, and planar projection or the azimuthal projections are mostly used for polar regions. This is azimuthal projection. After azimuthal projection, we have conical projection. A conical projection is made as if a cone is resting over a globe. You can see over here. So it's a map made by projecting the points on the lines from globe onto a cone. So wherever the cone touches the globe at a particular line, right, which on whichever latitudes. So where is there, wherever this cone is touching the globe, there are no distortion or very less distortion in the shapes of landmarks, right? But as you move away from the place where the paper cone is not touching the globe, the distortion increases, right? So these are the three types of projection. Hope that you have understood. We'll see the other concept in the next video. Subscribe and like, and do share your comments in the comment box. Bye bye.